Embattled Karamoja Minister Mary Goretti Kitutu had filed an application to hold the Inspector General of Government from prosecuting her. Kitutu wanted the court to permanently prohibit the IGG from indulging in what she described as endless investigations over matters touching the supplementary funds that were released to the office of a prime minister to support peace-building activities in the Karamoja sub-region in the 2021-2022 financial year, and which are similar in character with the investigations that led to the current charges against her pending in court.
Amendment on other human rights and freedoms and enforcement procedure rules provide that the court may grant reliefs, including A, a declaration of rights and freedoms, B, a declaration of invalidity of a law or conduct to the extent of inconsistency with the Constitution, C, an injunction or other prohibitory or restitutory order or decree, amongst others. The applicant sought a permanent injunction restraining the Inspectorate of Government from prosecuting the applicant in respect of the alleged mismanagement of supplementary funds released for peace-building activities.
Court, presided over by Justice Jane Kajuga, however, dismissed the application, thereby giving the IGG a go-ahead to start prosecutions against the Karamoja minister. In her ruling, Justice Kajuga noted that this case will not in any way impede the other case of the Iron Sheets.
Find A, that the acts of the second respondent of summoning and subsequently initiating parallel proceedings are founded on the same character with criminal charges for which she is already charged in case number 5 of 2023.
Kitutu is required to respond by way of criminal summons before the 29th of this month. In this particular case, the minister will first trial over matters touching the supplementary funds that were released to the office of the prime minister to support peace-building activities in Karamoja sub-region in the 2021-2022 financial year. Still in court, the International Criminal Division of the High Court has suspended the trial against MPs Alan Sewanyana and Muhammad Sejirinya until court determines a case in which one of the suspects, Mike Sirwada, claims he was tortured by the security officers as they forced him to pin the two letters to the 2021 massacre Kibijambia killings. Court was set to kick off with the trial today, but Sirwada complained that his case of torture had been abandoned, yet he's still suffering. Consequently, Justice Alice Komhanji suspended the hearing until Serwada's case is determined. Secondly, the judge could not proceed with the case hearing when one of the prime suspects in this case, Muhammad Sejirinya, is absent. His lawyers informed court that he is still critically ill in Aga Khan Hospital in Kenya.
Yeah, court finds itself in a very tricky situation that this is an illness that I don't think Honorable Sejirinya called for.
The matter was adjourned to the 26th of March when court expects to start the trial of the two legislators and their co-accused. Sejirinya and Alan Sewanyana are indicted with several counts of murder and terrorism in relation to the 2021 wave of Panga welding murders. Meanwhile, today the 28 suspects who were denied bail last year due to lack of substantial sureties have again appeared for their bail application hearing before the General Court Martial in Makindye. Several legislators turned up in court to stand surety for the suspects. However, journalists were locked out of court.
We decided to come and stand surety for them because in the past, the lawyers have been applying bail for them and the sureties have been their parents, their spouses, and other relatives. And court has said those are not substantial sureties. which we disagree with, because how do you say somebody's spouse, somebody's parent is not substantial enough to stand surety for them? So we said, as national leaders, let us come and stand surety for them, and then we wait and see if court is going to say that even we are not substantial. Then we shall ask court, tell us who then is substantial. If someone's parent is not substantial, if their spouse, if national leaders like ourselves are not substantial, who then qualifies, who is substantial to stand surety for these Ugandan citizens?
The same court on 3rd April 2023 granted bail to 4 suspects on grounds that their sureties were substantial. The released 4 were ordered to pay a cash bail of 500,000 shillings each and blocked from moving out of Kampala and Wakiso districts. The suspects, who were arrested in 2021 from different areas, are accused of being found in possession of 13 pieces of explosive devices, which are a monopoly of the defense forces. Rachel Achuala reporting for the news.